trigger warning, whatever.
Look where we are.
What's happening? Oh shit, they fell. Good morning, everyone. So it is now Monday morning, check-in day. We weighed in at 161.0. Hold on, the wife's calling right on time. Hold on. Hello. Like I said, we are heading to the gym to do some cardio because I discovered through my blood work and everything that I did recently that I am actually a universal donor. I am O positive, which means I could donate to anybody in the positives. So they are looking for people at the blood place I go to donate whatever they can. So I am actually trying to get over my fear of needles because I know I have tattoos. Okay, I understand. I have tattoos. It's different. For those of you that have tattoos and have a fear of needles, IV shots, stuff like that, you get me. Thank you. You understand. But I am trying to get over that fear because working in the hospital and being around so many people that need help and just being in the healthcare industry makes me realize how much people need these types of donations. And from the statistics that the blood place sent me, like, the majority of the percent of people that are universal donors don't donate because they don't want to. So I want to be the other, the ones that do donate, the ones that do give what they can. So I'm going to go donate platelets today. It's a 2-hour process, so I'm not too looking forward to that, but I'm not anxious, which is new for me. Usually I'm super anxious and I'm like sweaty and my heart rate's up and crazy and I don't want to do it, but it's for a good reason, and I'm going to be helping people, and that is enough for me to do this and to get over this fear. It hurts like a motherfucker to get that needle in my arm and out, but while I was sitting there, it really wasn't that bad. And I'm going to have my iPad and be editing the vlog from last week, so I'm going to be distracted, and I have my food. They have a ton of snacks there, like all the unhealthy things, like the Rice Krispie Treats, Pop-Tarts, all the sugary stuff, so I brought my own meals, my rice cakes, my berries, my protein, just so they can see that I'm well nourished, you know? So yeah, I'm gonna have all that with me. I'm gonna go to Vim and Vigor this morning and try to get in my cardio beforehand because after this, I am not allowed to work out. It's not in the cards. Even after my whole blood donation, I was woozy. Like going from sitting to standing too fast, I was almost like knocked on my ass. So that's what we're doing. We're starting the week off right. Going to donate some platelets. Try not to be nervous. It's at 11. It is now 9:30. So I'm gonna hope to get to the gym by 10, do 30 minutes of cardio, and then head straight to the place because it's in Carson City. So, okay, let's go get this done. So I've made it a point for myself to, oh my god, only do the Stairmaster now because I used to separate it between doing the treadmill and the Stairmaster for like the last few minutes of my cardio, but I made it a point now. I'm gonna only do the Stairmaster because it gets my heart rate up the most and I feel like I get the most out of it. So yeah, that's what I've concluded today. And we have to drink a ton of water. They wanted me to drink water before I came in. But I'm curious, if I have to pee, do they like unhook me and then have me pee? That's the real question. Or does it just suck the pee right out of you? Ugh, I feel like beans did get a little lift. Every time I
jump in her. It's like a fucking task. Why can't you see me? Hello? Okay, yeah. So I also don't want to smell bad. So I'm not gonna like overdo the spray, but I definitely smell like I've been sweating. So it's not cute. I don't want that. Also, not sponsored, but should be, Versace. Best smell ever. We've got to find this place because I don't know where it is. I also have my iPad, so maybe we'll get to watch something or edit my vlog, which I really hope I can do. I hope they stick this arm, even though they did this one last time. I'm hoping they can do that again. Shut up, Beans. I know you have no gas. Deal with it. Okay. So hopefully they can do that so I can use my right arm to edit. And my nurses told me that they don't have to use a 16. They can use an 18. So I'm gonna request an 18 because the 16 hurt, okay? This is how I walked in. I was ready. I was ready this time. I was fucking ready. And now I am tired. I am big EB right now. It took, let's see, appointment was at 11, started at about 11:30 maybe, and then got hooked up, got stabbed by the same awesome lady that helped me last time. Oof. And probably started giving around 11:45 and finished at 1:55. Well, pretty much 2 o'clock. So yeah, about 2 hours, which isn't, it wasn't bad. So this time they did use an 18 gauge. So it was a lot less painful, which is great. Excuse me. I did get my trigger warning. If you don't like bandages, I got green like I did last time, but they were so nice. I watched a whole movie on my iPad, edited some of the vlog. I didn't edit a lot of it because I don't know, I wasn't like invested in editing. I was more because I had to also squeeze this. That was the most tiring part, was squeezing the little ball, because the way it works, trigger warning, I'm gonna be talking about blood donation and blood, so if, whatever, trigger warning, whatever, whatever. So you're hooked up to one entry point, right? And there's three different tubes. There's one out, one in, and one pressure tube. So like one that keeps the, I don't fucking know. I didn't really, anyway. So it takes my blood and it puts it in a little machine that spins it. And then it separates the platelets to the plasma. And then it brings the blood back. So when it's drawing the blood, I have to pump my hand to get that draw to be a consistent speed. And then when it receives, which means it's giving me my blood back without the platelets, I don't have to squeeze. But the cool thing is when it receives, I feel cold because the blood is colder than when it went out. It's just so cool. And then like there's a reaction between the blood's being transferred that it makes your lips vibrate. Like my lips started to tingle. I was like, weird. And she's like, oh, just to let you know, your lips might vibrate. If you don't want that to happen next time, eat a calcium-rich meal. And I was like, okay, cool. Good to know. It was really cool, though. I had no complaints. Everybody is so sweet there. If you ever go to the Vitalant in Carson City, fucking top-notch people. They're so funny. They're humorous. They made the experience that much better. So I definitely will be going back. I have another appointment set for 2 weeks from now because I don't want to be like every single week and completely drain myself. I want to go probably every 2 weeks to donate platelets, and they're in high demand right now, so it was really cool. And I also looked at the chart. There are a lot of O positive peeps today, so I feel like I'm in my own little cult of O positive. Anyway, I'm tired, so I'm going to head home and take a nap if I can. But later today, when Leo gets back home from school, we're going to take him on his dirt bike for the very first time. He's gonna ride his dirt bike, and I'm so fucking pumped. And I'm gonna take you guys with me, obviously. We're gonna go to the sand pits right by our house. We live right next to it, so that's pretty rad. I'm gonna get gas first and then we're gonna head home. I'm gonna eat a couple meals because I am behind on them and it is already 2 o'clock. I didn't want to like whip out ground beef and green beans, so I just ate like my rice cakes and my strawberries. I came prepared this time, which is pretty dope. They gave me a blanket. I got all cold. It was great. So yeah, I'm gonna get home, get some gas, take a nap, and I'll see you guys when I'm rejuvenated a little bit. Goodbye. Yeah, my cat's waiting for me, literally sitting by our slider, by our bedroom, and just waiting for me. So we're taking Leo out on the dirt bike today. Gonna see how it goes, try it out. We got almost the perfect weather. It's like slightly overcast. It's gonna be good. I'm pumped. We're all pumped. Hold on, I want to try something.
I decided to yeet for that.
She yoted.
We definitely got stuck. And Coach was like, put it in four low, idiot. And I was like, oh, you're right. I knew that. God. Buddy. Mm-hmm. You're funny.
I think so. Just a smidge. Oh, look at how the sun's coming through right there.
Yeah.
That looks cool. Let me get a picture of me in front of that.
Across the ocean, I burned some bridges on the way. Feels like forever here in the moment, just so forever see to stay. Don't wanna say too much, speak too soon, and scare your heart away.
So fucking dope. Holy shit. So fucking sick. Oh shit, they fell. I'm just kidding. They didn't. My camera's gonna die. He's getting it slowly. He's not gonna get it all today, but he's learning, and that's pretty cool. So hopefully he loves it. His friend couldn't come out tonight to help him, but I think that might have just like might make him nervous to have a friend out here trying to help him learn. But he's doing really good. He's getting a little discouraged, but I get it. But I think we're gonna head home here soon, and I'll check in with you guys tomorrow morning when we go to the gym because it is Tuesday. Take that off today, because what do I have to be self-conscious about? Literally nothing. I'm like 16 and a half less out. 16 and a half weeks, or 16 and like some days out. So stop being fucking stupid, Sam. Stop. It's all in your fucking head.
You ripped.
Look where we are. What's happening? What could we possibly be doing here? Who knows? Okay, so even though Leo hasn't fallen in love with the bike yet, he bought him some stuff. Who's this? Me? Me? Pee-wee? Pee-wee? Knee? Elbow? Elbow guards? These sick gloves, which kind of matches bike-ish. And then, well, goggles. I'm mostly excited for these. I like the mirrored.
Are they youth?
Yep. Youth Zone.
Oh, those are sick.
Those are super cool. Oh, I like those a lot. Wow.
Yeah. So every day we're gonna practice, even if it's for an hour.
Oh yeah, we're gonna hit up a different spot though, one that's not so bumpy.
Yeah. Sand pits are pretty worn out. We're discouraged, which we all do.
First time I rode a dirt bike, I crashed it. Yep. Shout out to my ex. Those look pretty sick. That looks dope, dude. You look like a rider. Ooh. Okay, let me see. I'm gonna loosen them so they fit. Okay. That's why they were so loose. I forgot that they go around the helmet. So put them on your eyes first. On the back of the helmet. Got them on your eyes? Just like that. Does that feel okay or is it too tight?
You look so cool, dude.
Does this feel okay?
Yep. Where's my phone?
Your phone? I don't know.
Oh, it's in the glove box.
Parenting win. That's a parenting win. Proud parent?
Yeah.
Sorry, coach. Coffee all around. Oh, Leo, what are we about to go do?
Oh, God, my pants are cold.
What are we about to go do?
Look behind me. It's my dirt bike. We're gonna run my dirt bike with these.
He's got new gear. He's got new goggles. We're ready to go. We're officially starting to become dirt bike moms. I'm super excited about it. Ready for it. Ready for this new adventure. This is what we call dad boat. Okay, now we're back to Cali.
Did you cut up?
Nice.
I'll take a picture of you with your bike here in a second.
Okay.
I can hold it when you jumped up. You could probably get it. It's really not that heavy. So they have ramps that have stairs next to them.
Oh, that'd be tight.
Yeah. But warm up.
I was watching this video online, this girl named Mia Sayoko, and she did the 75 hard challenge. I want to know, do you guys think that the 75 is a good idea? Like, is it, because the way she did it beautifully. She had like actual DEXA scans, which told her all of her progress, and it can be deceiving when you don't physically see the progress, but she did it, and oh my God, you have to watch it. If you don't watch it, you need to. Got me thinking. Do you think it's good for people that have never done a workout plan before? Or do you think it's like detrimental to put yourself through such a hard challenge? Like, I want to know your thoughts. Have you tried the 75 hard? I've never tried it.
What did you think? Do you think it's a good idea for newbies? Do you think it's only for people who are experienced? Do you think it could build long-term habits? Or do you think it'll just build short-term and it'll just go one ear out the other? I want to know. Tell me your thoughts. We got the child in the car. We got the dirt bike in the car for the child. Everything's off. Let's go. Oh, shit. Also, happy Saturday. We're without everything in the Jeep except for the two doors and the, on Leo's side. People that we've never met before to teach Leo how to ride a dirt bike. We're very excited.
Yes.
Very, very excited. Right, buddy?
Yes.
So we're hopefully going to get some good time in.
I can't.
Get some good riding in. Pump.
I'm going to grab him some snacks real quick.
All right. Excited?
Yeah.
I'm very excited. Hungry. and all the doors are off. Afternoon. It is Sunday, and today is typically the day that we end the vlog. And I just wanted to say, this week, why am I not in focus? Okay, I just wanted to say that this week has been fucking amazing. Going out to Tabletop to teach Leo how to ride the dirt bike, our new friends and family, like this whole family that we went with up to Tabletop. Absolutely incredible people. The husband and the wife and the kids just are so incredible, and we're just so grateful to have done that. But this is gonna be the end of the vlog for this week, and I will pick up the camera again tomorrow to start our vlog for next week. But as far as the end of this week, I'm feeling good. Feeling about the same as far as physique-wise, but that's okay. Probably not the same. We probably tightened up a bit more, but we'll see tomorrow morning when we do our weigh-in. Although I did just eat, so of course I feel heavy. So yeah, this week has been good. Like, it's been really, really good. We did a lot of fun stuff. Next weekend, this weekend, we're not going to be doing any lessons, I don't think. But the weekend after, we're gonna go out again to the sand and have another lesson with Leo. So I'm very excited about that. And we're also gonna get him some boots and a chest plate and something that he really likes. Cause what we have right now is kind of hand-me-down, not the best quality. He hates wearing it because of how it looks. Very grateful to have it because at least it's something, it's better than nothing. But he definitely wants his own stuff, which I completely agree. And if that helps him get motivated and wanna learn how to do this, then I'm all for it. And he does love it, we're not forcing him to. We've asked him multiple times, like, it's okay if you don't like it. We're just giving it a try, but he loves it. So. Very excited about that. We're gonna be dirt bike moms. I'm so pumped. And there's like a 7-year-old in this family and a 4-year-old who all ride. And the 7-year-old has raced. Like, that's fucking nuts. And I really hope that Leo is loving it as much as he says. But thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next week. Bye.